If your camera is not a character in the film, if your lighting is not a character in your film, as David Mamet used to say to me, Gabby, your camera has to be a character. You are not crew, you are cast.
Yeah.
Your camera is cast in my film.
With this idea of camera being cast, how does that change the way that you film? Like, because we've had a lot of DPs on the show, a lot of different types of philosophies about the way people shoot. If camera is cast, then what does that mean for the cast? How are you integrated into the scene? Because it sounds like you're saying you're not just filming the scene, you're a part of it. And what does that mean to you?
Well, just to give you a very specific example, obviously this is a tremendous abstraction, because it's not about, okay, in order to be part of the scene, you have to put the camera here and not here. No, I think the most important thing is to know that scene, what this scene needs to be is you need to be audience, and you need to be really behind, and you need to be really very respectful and far away. It's like when you're acting live. So your camera now is going to be observing, and it's going to be there. But sometimes people, you want to be there. You want to be very close to the scene. Like, for instance, Kurosawa, when he did The Last Samurai, he has a scene in which a grandfather dies in the film. He's dying. And his camera position was three quarters back, one of the camera positions that he had. And a lot of the scene was played there. Something that you cannot do nowadays. Nowadays, the studios will force you to always be in the front and see the eyes of the characters and be there. Come what may, you have to do that. So what I did in Black Widow, as I tend to do in several things, is try to have three cameras. In a way that they are not three cameras, one together with the other one. What I do is one of the cameras, at least one of the cameras, goes somewhere else and starts trying to find those angles that it would be very important to see and feel like what people, if you were a person there in the film, what would you like to be? You would like to whisper? You would like to be respectful and go really far? Would you like to be hovering? Would you like to be would you like to accompany? And if you start thinking that your camera, like somebody that is there, and then you use those terms.
When you ask those questions, like, would you like to be respectful further away? Would you like to hover? Are you asking that of the camera operator? Is that what you mean?
No. You ask to yourself. You ask to yourself to start creating. Then you tell the camera operator, now, what you're going to do now is that. So if the camera operator, the steady cam operator, feels like it is do the movement, and then we need to charge and get into the camera. But in that particular moment, that absolutely typical steady cam movement in which we go around, which I use, for instance, a lot in Blade 2 with Guillermo del Toro, and then we move and we go in.
Yeah.
But in this case, again, because I'm working for the story, in this particular moment, what is happening is I want the Steadicam not to do that. On the contrary, I want the Steadicam to start very close. And when the drama starts getting very heavy, not to be intrusive to the drama. Now, in this moment, when she's saying something that I'm in a close-up, for instance, and the character is saying something to the character, in this case, the two sisters talking to each other.
Yeah.
Scarlet with Florence. Well, in that moment, yes, I'm on Scarlet and she's talking, but now I feel like if I don't see them together, it's not completely right. Now I need to see that emotion in Florence. But I don't feel that I should just give them the cut. They will have the cut. They will have the close-up on Florence reacting to Scarlet. But what about if my camera now, what it's going to do, is going to start with Scarlett and it's going to develop and it's going to end up in a very intimate close-up of both of them. In the same way that you, as if you were there, a fly, you were invisible, you say, okay, Scarlett is talking. He's talking to Florence. And what is Florence doing? And then you move around because you want to see both of them.
It sounds like you're approaching the cinematography almost like a person in the room that's curious about what's going on. Like, if you were in this room, what would you want to see? Where would you like to go? Where does the action pull you to? It's an interesting approach. I like that a lot.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I always do it like, I always try to do it like that. I always try to be like that. Because, okay, I come, first of all, I come from the tradition of the very strong Mexican visual influence, which I never participated, I never partake. I'm very Mexican, very, very Mexican. My mom still lives in Mexico. But I'm not part of this phenomenal group of talented Mexicans. I'm not part of Iñárritu, Lubezki's, Cuarón's, Del Toro, even though I worked with Guillermo, that was one film. But I don't, because I didn't make my career in Mexico like they did. And they did phenomenal. They were really, really good. So when I went to England, where I did my career, I worked very much in the theatrical world. Mm. And in that I learned, but I felt like, you know, I've worked with people like Ken Russell. So when we did, for instance, the first promo for Phantom of the Opera, remember the musical? I did the first one was done with Ken Russell, that we nearly burned the whole bloody theater. But it was very important because Ken said, we are going to do something that this video needs to do something. People are going to come here to see the musical and they're going to sit down in the theater and they're going to be watching the spectacle. No question, because that's what it is. It's a beautiful. So let's give now the audience in this promo the only thing that they cannot achieve, which is to come on the stage and to be close to the actor. And to feel them there, and yeah. to see the emotions, and see the face of the phantom very close, and smell it, and smell that. So that
we've never had that ability before. We've never been able to get that close to the characters before. The way you experienced Phantom, you couldn't do it before.
That's right. So that experience to me, so when I decided that when I started making more films, then I said, I want to take, you know, if I want to do anything in my life as a cinematographer, that's what I want to do. I think if I want to have a gimmick, I'm not going to have a 24 frames, 45 degree shot or 23, or my gimmick is not going to be to shoot, never to shoot with a wide lens or with a tight lens. So let's use all of them. Whatever I need to use, I will use. Whatever camera I need to use, I will use. Whatever thing I need to use, I will use. But let me try to at least grab the audience with my hand and say, come on, come up. Let's go and let's go close. Let's move around. Let's see. Let's be respectful. Let's move back. But be there. Let's enjoy that tremendous experience to feel Scarlett Johansson feeling and speaking to our emotions.